Hello, my name is Narissa and welcome to my kitchen. Today we are going to make a carrot cake. For that we need already started by preheating the oven to 180 degrees Celsius or 356 degrees Fahrenheit on convection. For the dough, we start with 180 grams of soft butter or margarine, 145 grams of sugar. I will use a 50-50 mix of white caster sugar and brown cane sugar. The cane sugar will add a caramelic hint of taste that goes very well with the natural sweetness of the carrots. Further, we need a pinch of salt and a pinch of vanilla bean. Mix everything well. Originally, I had planned to use 2 eggs for the recipe, but they mysteriously vanished from the fridge last night. My guess, Mr. Fox had a midnight snack. So we have to get creative. To improvise a replacement for the eggs, I take 6 tablespoons of mineral water, 4 tablespoons of soy flour and a pinch of baking powder, 60 grams of silken tofu, or if you don't have that, a piece of ripe banana. By mixing, you will get a stiff mass that resembles beaten egg white. Add the egg replacement, or the eggs, to the dough. Perfect! Next we need the carrots. They obviously make the carrot cake a carrot cake. I already prepared 360 grams finely grated carrots. That looks mouth-watering. And again, mix everything well. Yummy. Now it's time to add the 180 grams of flour. Gently sieve it in. Then we add 3/4 of a teaspoon of cinnamon. And 2 tablespoons of baking powder. Now mix everything in. For the final touch, we add 150 grams ground almonds or almond flour. That's good. To lift the dough, we add 1/4 teaspoon baking soda and 1 teaspoon of apple cider vinegar. So, grab the mixer and give the dough 1 final dance. That looks easier than it is, though foxes know how to handle sticky messes. it's time to fill the already greased springform pan. To grease the form, take a tiny piece of butter and spread it with your paws. Don't worry about the fuss, there is plenty in the dough already. For that cake, I used a pan with 28 cm in diameter. Spread the dough evenly with a wet spatula. And now, up into the oven. A good sippy sippy on coffee can change a day. So, for the cream cheese frosting, we originally needed cream cheese, but that looks empty, and my guess, another midnight snack for Mr. Fox. So we have to improvise again. For the frosting, you can use 290 grams cream cheese, or as in our case, 230 grams of almond yogurt and 60 grams of almond flour. You can also use soy yogurt and soy flour, but I prefer almond since they already bring a certain natural sweetness. By mixing both together, you will get a creamy mess that resembles cottage cheese. For the final frosting, we mix in 120 grams powdered sugar bit by bit. Take your time on that. For additional taste, you can also add a dash of lemon juice and a pinch of thin vanilla bean. Let the frosting settle in the fridge until the cake is cooled down to be decorated. Good to know. Oh, hello, Mr. Fox. Oh. Please protect your paws when handling hot objects. And now, the final pinch test. No dough sticks to the wooden skewer, means it's well done. Though I wonder, are there any food lovers out there liking their cake medium or rare? Set the cake aside and let it cool before we remove the baking pan and finish it off. Now that the cake has cooled down to room temperature, we place it on a large, nice plate. Or just a large plate if your dishes are unfriendly. By now, the frosting is cold enough to be spread on the cake evenly with a spatula. Be generous. The cake can handle it. Then we finish the cake off with some decor carrots and some chopped pistachios. you can caramelize some grated carrots as well. Bonus points for everyone managing without dirtying your fur. Well done! And now the pistachios. And done! That was easy! The cake remains fresh in the fridge for 3 to 4 days. But honestly, who takes that long to eat cake? It looks good, isn't it? Delicious. I am very pleased. Now the guests can come. Thank you, Jimmy, for being our guest. Now it's your turn to spoil your guests and loved ones. I hope you turn in next time when Nom presents Sweet Treats with Wixen. My name is Narissa and thank you for watching.